China ultimately intends to take Taiwan. That is not, in their mind, negotiable. That right. either happens peacefully because Taiwan simply says, okay, or it happens because China uses sufficient threat and or use of military force to make it happen. Is it fair to say China fully intends to execute on that one way or the other in the relatively near term? I don't mean months, but I mean that's not optional in their eyes. And given that, is it fair to assume at some point, whether it's 5 years or whatever, they're going to do something, because Taiwan's not going to just fold up and go, okay, and they're going to do something to force this issue. And it will, and I guess what I'm saying is it will involve military action, whether there's a conflict or not. It's not going to happen by a handshake. It's going to happen by a massive use of force, a threat of force. Is that fair?
Absolutely. And I think the prevailing wisdom and what you see in the Pentagon reports, the Pentagon China report specifically said they might try something like a blockade. So to cut off the area and force a major confrontation and force us or the U.S. and the West and its allies to think this is just too costly. Right? The whole fait accompli notion. I would suggest that given the uptick in tensions and the uptick in activity, there's of course a potential element of posturing here, but certainly the significance of Chinese intent to take over Taiwan is not lost on the Pentagon. And I wouldn't be surprised if there weren't serious concerns that it could be much closer term than had been thought of previously.
All right. Well, that's scary, but true, as we say.
That's why there's the big push for deterrence, and that has to work, which is why you see the Navy doing drills and doing all the way through the Pacific. U.S. Pacific Command only has 106,000 or so U.S. personnel based there. However, it's maritime power, it's undersea power, it's surface power, and it's allied power, which is why you see such a growing participation from South Korea, Japan, Australia. That collective effort would be very formidable, it seems to me, just looking at numbers and being familiar with what China writes in its newspapers and what we have would favor the West, it would seem to me.